गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी विल स्टार्ट चैप्टर 9 सीक्वेंसेस एंड सीरीज। एज वी नो दैट इन क्लास 10th वी हैव स्टडीड चैप्टर अर्थमेटिक प्रोग्रेशन एपी। दैट चैप्टर इज द बेस ऑफ दिस चैप्टर। इफ यू नो अबाउट अर्थमेटिक प्रोग्रेशन एपी देन it will be easy for you to do exercise first and second in this chapter. As you have studied sequence and series, just recall the arithmetic progression concept. Here, I think whenever you start the chapter, you have to read the summary of the chapter. This will give you knowledge, previous knowledge testing also, and give knowledge regarding the topic which is going on. Here it is written that introduction. In this introduction, the word sequence is used in mathematics, the word sequence is used in much the same way as it is in ordinary English. It means meaning of English sequence word and the mathematical sequence word, both are the approximately same. When we say that a collection of objects is listed in a sequence, we usually mean, it means what? When we list the objects in a sequence, it means that we know the first number, second number, third number, and we can predict the next number and so on. For example, population of human being or bacteria at the different times for form a sequence. The amount of money deposited in a bank over a number of years form a sequence. Here you can take the example when there is a amount which you deposit in a bank is a fixed amount every year. Then what? It means you are getting a sequence. Second, depreciated value of the certain commodity occurs in a sequence. It means decrease in the value. Depreciation in the value means decrease in the value. Certain commodity occurs in a sequence. Sequences have important applications in several spheres of human activities. It means use of sequences in human activity is common. Now here in this chapter, we will study three types of sequences. First, as you have studied, that is AP. I told you this also you have studied in the class 10th, that is a AP. Second, we will study geometrical progression, geometrical sequences progression. And third one, special cases. Third one will be special. Special cases of sequences. It means we will do three types. First is AP, second GP, third one will be special cases. And in between these topics, we will study, along with this AP, we will study arithmetic mean, arithmetic progression as well as arithmetic mean. Second, geometrical progression as well as GM, geometrical mean. It means four topics we will study here. Arithmetic progression as well as with arithmetic mean, geometrical progression and geometrical mean. And fifth topic will be special cases of the sequences. We'll study these topics in this chapter. Let's see few revision we'll do here. In this revision, I think you know yes, a few important points which you have to know. First, the number of the persons, ancestors for the first, second, third. Here, one sequence is given to you. I just want to tell you 2, 4, 8, 16, 32, 1, 0, 2, 4. This last one is given to you. It means these terms are countable. If these terms are countable, then these are known as finite sequence. If another example is here given, 3, 3.3, 3.33, 3.333, this is the sequence which will continue endlessly. It means this is the sequence which is infinite sequence. Infinite. This is infinite sequence. Finite sequence, infinite sequence. These two terms are here. Now next one. If in class 10th you have studied that, if you want to write down the arithmetic sequence or any sequence, then first term will be represented at a1, second a2, then a3 up to an. An means nth term of the sequence. Nth term of the sequence, it means the nth term is the number at the nth position of the sequence. Nth term is the nth position of the sequence. Or you can say nth term is called as generalization, general term of the sequence. As you have studied in chapter binomial theorem, general term means what? You are getting each and every term by using the general term. Same is here. I think you have know about it. An is the general term. It is used in sequences. Whenever an is written, you have to know it is a general term of the sequence. It means when you put n is equal to 1, you will get a1. When you put n is equal to 2, you will get a2. N is equal to 3, you will get a3, third term, and so on. The terms of the sequence of the persons, ancestors mentioned above, this one, finite sequence, a1 is 2, a2 is 4, a3 is 8. From this finite sequence, you can find a1, a2, a3, and a10 is the 10241024. In the second example here, in the infinite sequence, it is a1 is 3, a2 is 3.3, a3 is 3.33, and so on. An will be what? A6 up to it, an will be what? An is equal to 3.33333, and so on. A sequence containing finite number of terms is called finite sequence. I have told you. And infinite number of terms, if they are, then finite sequence. As we can study here. Yes, we can study here. Let's see. Yes. Whenever you... Yes. Whenever you talk sequence, I have told you an is a general term. Next, we will discuss about this important line. A sequence can be regarded as a function whose domain is a set of natural numbers or some subset of it. It means what? This is an important line. You have to underline it. A sequence can be regarded as a function whose domain is a set of natural numbers or some subset of it. It means what? An is equal to, I have told you, an is a general term. You can put the value of n by taking values 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6, and so on. It means you are putting natural numbers. It means what? Domain is what? Is a natural numbers or a subset of it. It means maybe whole natural numbers up to infinite. Or otherwise, maybe number of terms are 10. It means you have to take only from n is equal to 1 to 10. If the number of terms are 100, it means n is equal to 1 to 100. You have to take like this. It means this is an important part which you have to, I think, underline it. This is a question which can be asked in the exam in 1 mark questions. What is the domain of the sequence? This is the important part. You have to underline it and learn it. Okay, because the value of n in an is only started from 1 to and so last up in the from the natural numbers, or it may be, you can say that it is a subset of natural numbers. Now what is series? Next important point in the theory is series. If number of terms are written like this, a1, a2, a3, it means you are writing a sequence. If there is a sum sign in between it, suppose like this, a1 plus a2 plus a3, it means you made the expression from this sequence by putting the plus sign in between the terms. It means this becomes a series. this is called the series associated with the given sequence. Whatever sequence is given to you, if you make the expression by putting positive sign in the term, then you will get the series. Now here one important part is given here. This series can be represented in compact form by using the sign sigma. A1 plus A2 up to AN. This can be written as summation of AK, K is equal to 1 to N. K is what? K is any natural number. K is any natural number. Is it clear? Now here is remark is given. If the series is used, it refers to the indicated sum, not to the sum itself. For example, 1 plus 3 plus 5 plus 7 is a finite series with the four terms. When we use the phrase sum of a series, we will mean that the number that results from adding the terms. It means what? When sum of series word is used, what is the meaning of this will be? It means that you added all the terms and whatever you will get, that is known as a sum of the series. And in further, you will notice this will be denoted by S of N. It means sum of series means a total of all the terms. Whatever number you will get, that number is known as the sum of the series. Now, we will do example. Example number one. Example number one is skipped here. This example number one is not there. Just do example number two. Let's move on to the next slide. Yes, do example number two, where you will find how to find out the terms by using the general term. I have told you general term means what? General term means in AP you used general term, that is AN is equal to A plus N minus 1 into D. What was the meaning of this when you used it in 10th class? When you put N is equal to 1, you get first term, 2, second term, 3, third term, 4, fourth term. This is the general term of the AP. Till now, we have not talked about AP. It means any general term can be given to you. You have to find out the terms which are given to you. Here general term is given, suppose an is equal to n minus 1 into 2n minus 2 minus 1 into n plus 3 plus n. Then 20th term you have to calculate. It means what? When you put n is equal to 20 in the general term, then you will get the a20 20th term. You can be calculate by using putting the n is equal to 20. 20 minus 1 19, 20, 2 minus 20 minus 18, 3 plus 20, 23. Multiply it, you will get the 20th term. And this AN is the general term of any sequence which is not known to you here. You can find the sequence by putting N is equal to 1, 2, 3, and 4, and so on. You can get the sequence. In the next question, let a sequence AN be defined as A1, you have to take 1. An is equal to an minus 1 plus 2. This. It means general term is an is equal to an minus 1 plus 2. And this first term is given to you. And here it is written that you have to take n greater than equal to 2 for this general term. It means in this general term, you have to start to put from 2. When you put 2 here, then you will get a2. And this is 2 minus 1, a1. Plus 2 and you will get A2 is equal to A1 plus 2. What is A1? That is 1. It means 1 plus 2, that is equal to 3. If you want A3, it means you have to put N is equal to 3 and here it will be 2. a2 plus 2. a2 is 2. a2 is 3 plus 2, that is equal to 5. Similarly, if you want a4, then put n is equal to 4. a4 will be equal to a3 plus 2, and a3 is 5. 5 plus 2, that is 7, and you can find any of term by using this general term. Okay. Here it is written that you have to find out 5 terms. It means you can find 5 terms and write the corresponding series. Series you have to write down. It means this is the sequence 1, 3, 5, 7, 9. Now, next part of this question is you have to write down series. I have told you series means all these terms are collected by putting the positive sign in between the terms. 1 plus 3 plus 5 plus 7 plus 9 and so on. This is the series of the given sequence. Okay. Now you can do the exercise. Exercise 9.1. When you will start exercise, in this exercise, question number, I have just here, question number 14, I want to discuss with you. Other questions you can do. This 14th question is the special type of sequence. Sometime it is asked in a 1 mark questions, what is Fibonacci series? Fibonacci series. This is Fibonacci sequence. What is Fibonacci series, your sequence? In this sequence, first term is 1. A1 is 1. Second term is again 1. A2 is 1. Now what is A3? Here it is written that for n greater than 2, you can put the value here and you will get the sequence. If you want A3, it means A3 will be equal to 3 minus 1 is 2, A2 plus A, put 3, 3 minus 1 is 2, and this is 3 minus 2 is 1. You will get A2 plus A1, you will get next is 2. If you want A4, it means it will be A3 plus A2. This will be 3. A4 means A4, 4 minus 1 is 3, and 4 minus 2 is 2. A3 plus A2, A3 means second, 2, and this is A2, this is 1. 2 plus 1 is 3. Now, if you want A5, A5 means 5 minus 1, this is 4, A4 plus A5 minus 2, that is A3. I think you can observe previous two terms sum is the next term. A3 plus A4, 3 and 4, this comes out 5. Now you can predict what will be the next. 3 plus 5, that will be 8. Next one will be 8 plus 5, that is 13. Next one will be 13 plus 8, 21. And next one will be 21 plus 13, 34. And so on. And so on. It means what? This is special type of series in which what? You are getting terms. Here you can see here. You can see first term is 1, second term is 1, 1 plus 1. Sum of these two is 2. 2 and plus 1, that is 3. 3 plus 2, you are getting 5. 5 plus 3, you are getting 8. And 8 plus 5, you are getting 13. 13 plus 8, you are getting 21. 21 plus 13, you are getting 34. It means you can predict further all the values of the sequence. Now you can do the question and remember it. What is the Fibonacci series or sequence? Okay. In this question, second part is also there. Here is it is a second part. Find a of n plus 1 upon an. Find the value and ratio, write the ratio. You can do the question further. I think when you put n is equal to 1, you will get what? A2 upon A1. A2 upon A1. You have to find out 1 upon 1. Then next one, when you put n is equal to 2, A3 upon A2. A3 means 2 upon 1. 2 upon 1. And find the ratio of the terms by using the general term, that is an plus 1 upon an. I think you can do the exercise 9.1. Now further, the part which you have done in class 10, that is arithmetic progression. In the arithmetic progression, we will discuss general term of the arithmetic progression and how to find out the sum up to n terms of the given sequence which is in AP. And now what is an AP? We will discuss here. What is an AP? AP is a sequence. AP is a sequence in the arithmetic progression. What you have to remember, what is the general term? I will just give you idea about AP because you have studied in class 10. Just after getting an idea, you can do the questions because same formula will be here in the exercise 9.2. What are the important points? Just discuss in AP. Important points are, first of all, how to write down AP. What is the meaning of AP? When the two consecutive terms have same difference in the sequence, then that sequence is known as the AP. Or you can say that whenever I write down first term, that will be A, second is A plus D, third is A plus 2D, A plus 3D, and so on. And in the sequence, general term is equal to An is equal to A plus N minus 1 into D, you know it well. And what is Sn? That is n by 2 into 2a plus n minus 1 into d. This is a sum of n terms of the AP at the general term. You have to try the questions or examples first by using these two formulae, and you will get an idea of doing the questions of AP. Little bit different, extra you will look questions here, but try these examples and try exercise. In next lecture, we will discuss a few important questions of AP of exercise 9.2. Thank you. Have a nice day.